We're now ready for the second round with 9 contestants. Let's get started with contestant number 1. Your word is teleological.
May you please repeat the word?
Teleological.
May I have its meaning?
Teleological means relating to or involving the explanation of phenomena in terms of the purpose they serve rather than the cause by which they arise.
Can you please repeat the word?
Teleological.
T-E-L-E-O-L-I-G-I-C-A-L.
Teleological. Said L-I-G-I. And to be fair, like you had said that even before the interruption, so I'll accept that as the answer. Thank you. Contestant number 2. Your word is Bildungsroman.
Is it Bildungsroman?
Absolutely right. Next we have contestant number 6. Your word is Glengarry.
Glengarry. Can you repeat the word, sir?
Glengarry.
May I have the definition?
Glengarry is a brimless boat-shaped hat with a cleft down the center, typically having 2 ribbons hanging at the back.
Can you repeat the word, sir?
Glengarry.
G-L-E-N-G-A-R-R-Y.
That's correct. Contestant number 7. Your word is skeuomorph.
Can you repeat the word again?
Skeuomorph. Skeuomorph is an object or feature which imitates the design of a similar artifact made from another material.
S-K-E-W-O-M-O-R-P-H.
S-K-E-U-O-M-O-R-P-H. Contestant number 8. Your word is humectant.
Could you repeat the word?
Humectant.
May I have the definition, please?
Humectant means retaining or preserving moisture.
Humectant. H-U-M-E-C-T-I-N-T.
Very close. It's T-A-N-T. Next, we have contestant number 9. Your word is hacienda.
Could you please repeat the word?
Hacienda.
May I get its definition?
Hacienda, typically in Spanish-speaking countries or regions, is a large estate or plantation with a dwelling house.
Could you please repeat the word?
Hacienda.
Is it H-A-C-I-E-N-D-A?
Absolutely right. Next, we have contestant number 11. Your word is astrobleem.
May I have the word again?
Astrobleem.
Astrobleem. May I have the meaning?
Astrobleem is an eroded remnant of a large crater made by the impact of a meteorite or comet.
A-S-T-R-O-B-L-E-M-E.
That's correct. Next we have contestant number 15. Your word is happenstance.
Happenstance. May I have the meaning?
Happenstance means coincidence.
H-A-P-P-E-N-S-T-A-N-C-E.
That's correct. Finally, we have contestant number 16. Your word is oniromancy.
Oniromancy. Can I have the meaning, please?
Oniromancy is the interpretation of dreams in order to foretell the future.
Can I have the word again?
Oniromancy.
Oniromancy.
That's correct. Okay, we have 6 contestants remaining in the competition. We'll continue with our one word elimination. So let's call contestant number 2, please. Your word is riparian.
Riparian. May I have the meaning, please?
Riparian means relating to or situated on the banks of a river.
May I have the word again?
Riparian.
R-I-P-A-R-I-A-N.
Brilliant answer. That's absolutely right. Next we have contestant number 6. Your word is spiccato.
Spiccato. Can I get the definition, sir?
Spiccato is a style of staccato playing on stringed instruments involving bouncing the bow on the strings.
S-P-E-C-C-A-T-O.
S-P-I. Contestant number 9. Your word is silicet or siliceet.
Could you give me the definition?
Siliceet or siliceet, that is, it means, that is to say, or namely, basically introducing a word to be supplied or an explanation of an ambiguity.
Is it S-I-L-A-C-E-T-E?
S-C-I-L-I-C-E-T. Siliceet or siliceet. Next we have contestant number 11. Your word is whippet.
May I have the word again?
Whippet.
Whippet. May I have the meaning?
It means a dog of a small, slender breed originally produced as a cross between the greyhound and the terrier.
W-H-I-P-P-I-T.
P-P-E-T. Like snippet. Okay. Contestant number 15. Your word is Darwin. Darwin in Judaism, it means to recite the prescribed liturgical prayers.
Darwin.
Darwin.
Darwin. D E A R V E N.
It's a little shorter than that. It's D A V E N. Darwin. Okay. Finally, we have contestant number 16. Your word is Marin.
Marin.
Marin is a large Australian freshwater crayfish which lives on the sandy bottoms of rivers and streams.
Marin.
Marin.
Can I have the meaning again?
A large Australian freshwater crayfish.
Is it M-A-R-R-I-N?
O-N. Marin.
Thank you.
So we have one contestant who got the word right, which basically means that we have our gold medal winner. Please give it up for contestant number 2. That's Akshara from Konaseema Vidyashram, Mukteshwaram, East Godavari. Please stand up. Let them give you a big round of applause. Now we have 5 contestants remaining. So let's do a speed round now. You basically get 5 words that you need to spell correctly in 1 minute. Let's have contestant number 6. We have the timer on screen, please. Okay. Your 60 seconds starts now. Usury.
Usury. U-S-U-R-Y.
That's correct. Abyssal.
Abyssal. A-B-Y-S-A-L.
Incorrect. Squamous.
Squamous. S-Q-U-A-M-O-U-S.
That's correct. Duan.
Duan. Can I have the definition?
Duan means a custom house in France or other Mediterranean countries.
D-U-O-N.
No, Duan is D-O-U-A-N-E. And your last word, Nasturtium.
Nasturtium. Can you repeat the word?
Nasturtium.
Nasturtium. Can I get the definition?
Nasturtium is a South American trailing plant with round leaves and bright orange, yellow or red flowers.
Nasturtium. N-U-S-T-E-R-T-I-U-M.
It's incorrect.
Okay, sir.
So, you've got 2 out of 5 correct. Great job. Please give her a huge round of applause. Next, we have contestant number 9. Your 60 seconds starts now. Contretemps.
Is it C-O-N-T-R-E-T-E-M-P-S?
It's correct. Fatuous.
Is it F-A-T-U-O-U-S?
Correct. Sitzmark.
Is it S-I-T-Z-M-A-R-K?
Correct. Interlocutor.
Is it I-N-T-E-R-L-O-C-U-T-O-R?
That's correct. Warthog.
Could you please repeat the word?
Warthog.
May I get its definition?
Warthog is an African wild pig with a large head, lumps on the face and curved tusks.
Is it W-A-T-H-O-G?
It's W-A-R-T-H-O-D. Warthog. Okay. Very well done. Contestant number 11. Your 60 seconds starts now. Frontistery.
P-H-R-O-N-T-I-S-T-E-R-Y.
Correct. Abecedarian.
A-B-E-C-E-D-A-R-I-A-N.
That's correct. Ricotta.
May I have the word again?
Ricotta.
Ricotta. R-E-C-O-T-T-A.
R-I-C-O-T-T-A. Machiavellian.
M-A-C-H-I-A-V-E-L-L-I-A-N.
That's correct. Alembic.
May I have the word again?
Alembic.
May I have the meaning, please?
Alembic is a distilling apparatus, now obsolete, consisting of a gourd-shaped container and a cap with a long beak for conveying products to a receiver.
Alembic.
Alembic.
A-L-E-M-B-I-C.
That's correct. Next we have contestant number 15. Your time starts now. Boysenberry.
B-O-Y-S-E-N-B-E-R-R-Y.
Correct. Judoka.
J-U-D-O-K-A.
Correct. Glockenspiel.
Glockenspiel. G-L-O-C-K-E-N-S-P-I-A-L.
It's incorrect. Caterwaul.
Caterwaul. C-A-T-T-E-R-W-A-L-L.
It's incorrect. And finally, civet.
Civet. May I have the meaning?
Civet is a ring-tailed cat.
S-E-V-I-E-T-T-E.
C-I-V-E-T. Civet. Contestant number 16. Your 60 seconds starts now. Lacrimal.
L-A-C-H-R-Y-M-A-L.
Correct. Sepia.
Sepia. Can I have the meaning?
A reddish-brown color associated particularly with monochrome photographs.
S-E-P-I-A.
Correct. Julep.
Can I have the meaning?
Julep is a sweet, flavored drink made from sugar syrup, sometimes containing medication or alcohol.
J-U-L-E-P.
Correct. Sylvestrian.
S-Y-L
V-E-S-T-R-I-A-N.
Correct. Diphthong.
Can I have the meaning?
A sound formed by the combination of two vowels in a single syllable.
D-I-P-H-T-H-O-N-G.
That's correct. That means we have a silver medal winner. That's contestant number 16, Lakshmi Navya Yarlagadda from TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. Now we have two contestants who are tied on 4 points each. So we'll have a single word elimination to find the bronze medal winner. Let's have contestant number 9. Your word is terrazzo.
Could you please repeat the word?
Terrazzo.
I get its definition.
Terrazzo is flooring material consisting of chips of marble or granite set in concrete and polished to give a smooth surface.
Could you please repeat the word?
Terrazzo.
Is it T-E-R-A-T-Z-O?
T-E-R-R-A-Z-Z-O. Terrazzo. Next we have contestant number 11. Your word is chintzy.
May I have the word again?
Chintzy.
Chintzy. May I have the meaning?
Chintzy means of, like, or decorated with chintz.
C-H-I-N-T-Z-Y.
That's correct. So we have our third place winner. That's contestant number 11, Narapareddy Nikhila Deepthi from TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. That brings us to the end of an exciting grand final for Category 4, Andhra Pradesh, of the Sakshi Spell Bee presented by Duke's Wafi in association with TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. We'd like to get the prize distribution started now. For that, I'd like to call on stage Miss Rani Reddy and Miss Balatripura Sundari. So the gold, silver and bronze medal winners, please stay seated. All our other finalists, please form a queue at the beginning of the stage here and come on stage one by one to collect your medals. Let's now have our bronze medal winner on stage, contestant number 11, Narapareddy Nikhila Deepthi from TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. Let's now have our silver medal winner, contestant number 16, Lakshmi Navya Yarlagadda from TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. And now for our gold medal winner, contestant number 2, Akshara from Konaseema Vidyashram, Mukteshwaram in East Godavari. There's one last prize to be given away today, and that is for Sakshi Spell Bee Champion School for Andhra Pradesh. And the winner of that award this year is TRIPS International School, Rajahmundry. They've got 4 silver medals and 3 bronze medals.